Alabama is the national champion.
It really couldn't have happened to a better bunch of kids in a classier school than this. They battled all year. Whenever it got tough, they came together and came out on top. And now they're on top of the polls, the world, everything. Everything.
Alright, boom. So this is your 15th season in Dynasty Mode. You get all the five-star recruits. You pick what player you want to win the Heisman with each season. And after that ninth natty, that trophy just don't seem alive anymore. Well, I'm here to give you some quick tips to turn that boring dynasty from easy to hard. It's pretty easy for real. First thing you want to do is be in the offseason of any dynasty you currently in, and then you want to simulate to position changes. Once you get the position changes, you want to turn everybody on the team to either a kicker or a punter. Once you're through with that, you want to advance to cut players in the offseason. Once you get to cut players, you'll notice that all your extra players will be replaced with nothing but walk-ons. Yeah, like all of them be in the 40s. Sometimes they be in like the 48 overall. I don't think they go past 48. I think that's the highest I've seen. But that's where the challenge come in at. The last step you want to do is just go to the kickers part of the roster and just start cutting all the old players off the team until you can't cut anybody else. And after that, you basically done. Advance to the next season and check out your championship contenders list. Alabama went from number 2 in the nation all the way to 126 for the projected next couple years. And you can see the difference. Check out this screenshot right here from last season when I was a 97, 97, 95. And now I'm 126 and everything, and even my whole grade and dropped to a C. The last thing you can do to make the challenge more difficult is to make recruiting harder, because it's so easy to build up a program in NCAA 14. You can do that by using a team builder that has everything in the recruiting aspects turned down, like my Montgomery Freedom Riders team. I'll leave a link in the description. The last thing y'all want to do if y'all want to make the challenge even more harder is to give yourself recruiting limits like I do in my Columbus State rebuild. And I can leave a link to that too. In my Columbus State rebuild, I'm based out of Georgia, so I'm only allowed to recruit any player that's higher than a 1-star out of the state of Georgia my first year. I like to use this rule because it make it a little harder for me to just blow up and not be this big powerhouse program like 1 year after having nothing but walk on. Alright y'all, these are the tips I got to make y'all Dynasty Mode that much more challenging. Leave a like and leave a comment on what some of the rules you use in your Dynasty Mode to make it a little bit more challenging so maybe I can try it out. And I know some of the people already say, hey, I already knew about this. Well, damn it, this for the people who didn't know. Hey, thank y'all for watching. Again, leave a like if you enjoyed the video and it helped you bring some life back to your Dynasty Mode. Peace out.